Hi everyone, it's Vicky here, and today I will be using these two stamp sets by the Precious Remembrance shop to create a fan card. As my coloring medium, I will be using these pigment inks. These are called Ising inks, and they come in various colors, but you can also use Liquitex ink for the technique that I will be showing you today if you have this type of ink. I am picking up a few colors which I am going to use for the background as well as for the focal points of my card. And if you take a closer look, I don't know if you are able to see the shimmer that is inside those inks, that it's not too much, but it adds a nice shine to your finished projects. So to start, I am going to use two colors in this watercolor paper, and I am going to start with the orange and the yellow. You can see the exact names of those colors that I am using just below in the details area. And I'm just adding a few drops. There is a nice cap with a dropper, so you can totally have control to the amount of ink that you are using. I am going to use these inks as if they were watercolor, and you can see that I can dilute them easily with water, and they blend nicely and they react pretty much like watercolor. However, when it dries, it will be permanent, so it will not react with water if I spray anything on top, which is a nice attribute if you consider that you are sending this card through the mail. I'm not doing any fancy watercoloring, I'm just applying two colors on the surface with a lot of water, which is going to help them blend. And when it dries, you get this nice background, which is also has a nice shine on it. I don't know if I can catch the light so you can see the shine. So to add a little more bit of interest on my background, I am going to do some splashes. And again, I'm using Ising ink, the white color. I'm using a small brush because I want to have tiny little splashes instead of big drops of color there. And to make it even more interesting, I repeated the same technique with a darker orange ink. And the watercolor that I like to use is this Canson aquarelle pad, which is 300 grams per square meter, and it's nice and thick. So I am going to link to this pad as well on the details below in the supply list. Now I am using this jar from the stamp set by the Precious Remembrance shop, and this stamp set is called Oh So Fun. And also I am going to stamp a couple of flowers from another set that is called Blossom. Now I am going to use some embossing powder. So first of all, I am going to stamp all my images on my watercolor paper with Versamark ink. Before I stamp, I make sure that I remove every static electricity from the paper, and that's what these embossing tools do. There are different types, as you can see, with a brush or like a pillow, which you can use directly on your surface because before you stamp. Now when I stamp, I will have a better result because the embossing powder is going to stick only where it's supposed to. So I'm stamping the jar there, and I'm going to add the embossing powder at the moment so I know where I have stamped, because it's white on white and you can't see a lot. And after that, and before heat setting everything, I am going to stamp and do the same technique with the flowers, and then melt the powder with my heat gun. I have heat set all the images, and I am now going to color the flowers as well as the jar. I wet the surface first with water, and then I am going to apply my ink using a brush that has a big amount of water. You will see how nicely it dilutes and it spreads on the watercolor paper. Now while I'm doing this watercoloring technique, which isn't anything fancy, I'm just applying color on the paper. And although you cannot see the white lines from the stamped image at the moment, you will see that at the end they will resist the ink. And I have a fun giveaway today on my blog, so I am giving away the two stamp sets that I am using to two lucky winners. And if you want to enter the giveaway, make sure to visit my blog and enter your details. If you are watching from YouTube, then you will find a link to my blog just below the video in the details area. And again, I am not doing anything fancy here. I'm just applying the ink with a lot of water. And now I am going to ink the jar. I'm just adding a little bit of color there. And just because I didn't have a lighter color than this, you will see what I'm going to do. I have applied the color, the ink, on the jar. And then I'm going to use my baby wipe to dab off the excess. So I get a lighter version of this color, while at the same time I get the watercolor effect. Now I am going to add a little bit more color at the bottom to do some shading for my jar. And just because my images are embossed, I'm not going to use my heat gun to speed up the drying process because I don't want to remelt the embossing powder. So I'm just going to leave this to dry. And then you can use a baby wipe to wipe off the excess ink, and it will reveal the embossed lines. Now, just because I wasn't too patient, I didn't wait enough, and it was just a little bit wet, and that's why I pick up color with my baby wipe. But if you are patient enough and you leave it a good time to dry, then the ink is going to be permanent, so it will not move. And now I can use my scissors to cut out the flowers and the jar. In the Oh So Fun stamp set, there are little triangles. One is solid, the other one has polka dots, and another one with stripes, which I am going to stamp with different colors. And I'm going to create a banner for my jar. So I'm using three different colors by Simon Says Stamp, and I am going to link all the colors just below in the details area. And I chose especially these colors because they really match the rest of the colors that I already have on my card. So I'm cutting out the triangles, and you can see that although I don't have a die for them, it's super easy to cut out since they are just straight lines. For my sentiment, I'm going to use two phrases from the same stamp set. So I'm going with celebrate and it's your day. I am going to place them one below the other, and I'm going to stamp them at the very bottom of my card using VersaFine black ink. You get a perfect impression every time. Now that my main background is ready, I can go ahead and assemble the jar. So I am drawing a line with my pencil so I can mark where I want to stick all those triangles. So the idea is to create a fun embellishment by creating a banner that goes all around the jar. I have cut out a piece of thread which I am going to glue just over the triangles to create my banner. To stick down the thread, I am using Tombow Mono Multi Glue, but you can use any type of glue with a fine tip applicator. And this thread is going to also cover up the line that I have drawn previously with my pencil. Now I am going to use my white gel pen to add some lines around the triangles, and this is going to help them pop more from their background, from the jar. Now that everything is ready, I am going to use a good amount of foam tape at the back of the jar, and I am doing so just because my jar was colored with a lot of water over watercolor paper, and I don't want this to be wavy. So I'm going to stick it on top of my card, and then I'm going to place with foam squares again the flowers on top. Thank you. To embellish the card just a little bit more, I'm going to stick 3 pearls at the center of the flowers. And my card is pretty much finished. All that's left to do is to stick this on top of a top folding card that's 4.25 by 5.5. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. Don't forget to visit my blog and enter the giveaway. Here are a couple of close-up photos of the project. Oh, and if you haven't done so already, make sure to subscribe to my channel, since this is the way to tell me that you love my videos and you want to see more. For more inspiration, here are 2 more card videos. And if you are watching from a mobile device, you can find the links just below in the description area, or you can click the card that just popped in on your screen. Thank you all for watching.